Are the IRS, FBI, U.S. Department of Labor, the Mafia, and labor unions part of the Vatican? Is the Pope the superboss of all government agencies, as well as the Vatican? The Pope's Secrets by Tony Alamo. This literature was written in 1983. The Vatican is posing as Snow White, but the Bible says that she's a prostitute, the great whore, a cult, Revelation 19:2. She uses government agency branches in every country, including the United States, as her vicious little dwarfs. The more power and control she gets in government, the more she will fade into the background in her Snow White disguise, so that government will be used and blamed for all her evil deeds. Reason: to enforce laws that harass, malign, destroy, and censor everyone and every idea that is not Roman Catholic, so she can sit as the satanic queen, the big whore. Because of her age-old desire to control the world government and church, the serpent-like Vatican has infested the world and the U.S. government with so many of her zealous, highly trained, and dedicated Jesuit devotees that she now controls the United Nations, which she created. The White House, Congress, every state, federal, civic, and social government agency, including the U.S. Department of Labor, the IRS, the FBI, the Supreme Court, judicial systems, the armed forces, state, federal, and other police, also the international banking and federal reserve systems, called the Illuminati and Agentur, labor unions, the Mafia, and most of the heavyweight news media. This cult, the Vatican, is very close to replacing our U.S. Constitution with her one-world satanic canon laws of death to the heretic, anyone who is not Roman Catholic. General Lafayette, President George Washington's most respected aide and general, prophetically stated, "If the liberties of the American people are ever destroyed, they will fall by the hand of the Roman Catholic cult's clergy." Today we see the climax of detailed plans given in excerpts from a speech given nearly 50 years ago in Australia by Roman Catholic Archbishop Gilroy. The Roman Catholic motto is "Ourselves alone for fellow Roman Catholics." We must defeat all heretics, non-Roman Catholics, at the ballot box. The Holy Father states that negative tactics are fatal. The demands of the Holy Father, the Pope, are that the public services should be 100% Roman Catholic soon. Care must be taken that no suspicion may be raised when Roman Catholics are secretly given more government jobs than Protestants, Jews, and other heretics. Multi-millions of people have been slaughtered by the Vatican, thus saith the Lord, Revelation 18:24. History bears record to this fact. During the Roman Catholic Inquisition in Europe, 68 million people were tortured, maimed, and murdered by this huge sect. The St. Bartholomew's Day Massacre accounted for the butchering of as many as 100,000 Protestants. Abraham Lincoln blamed the papacy for the Civil War in these words: "This war would never have been possible without the sinister and secretive influence of the Jesuits. We owe it to Popery that we now see our land reddened with the blood of her noblest sons. Lincoln added, "I am for liberty of conscience in its noblest, broadest, and highest sense. But I cannot give liberty of conscience to the Pope and to his followers, the Papists, so long as they tell me through their councils, theologians, and canon laws that their conscience orders them to burn my wife, strangle my children, and cut my throat when they find their opportunity." Because of Abraham Lincoln's many exposés of the Vatican, he was put to death, just as he foretold. Yes, assassinated by the Jesuits under Rome's instructions. The Vatican hasn't changed since Mr. Lincoln's time. JFK's fatal mistake. When John F. Kennedy was asked by the Vatican, "Are you going to go along with the Roman canon law or the U.S. Constitution?" Mr. Kennedy answered them by saying, "The U.S. Constitution." This was President Kennedy's fatal mistake. His assassination was ordered by Rome, then planned and carried out by Jesuits, just as President Lincoln's was. Anyone who knew too much about Mr. Kennedy's assassination was taken care of, too. When America cried out for an investigation, Chief Justice Earl Warren, a member of the Vatican's secretive Knights of Columbus, was recruited to do the investigation. He did a lot of double-talking and shuffling, as he was supposed to, and then, after a sufficient period of time, closed the investigation. Like the Pope says, negative actions are fatal. Remember that President Kennedy was a great admirer and student of Abraham Lincoln and knew what Mr. Lincoln knew. World War II, with its casualties of over 30 million deaths, 6 million Jews, the Holocaust, was conjured up and sponsored by the Vatican. Hitler, Mussolini, and Franco were all members of this sect, the Roman Catholic cult. To win the world not for Christ, but for the Vatican, the Antichrist. The turmoil in Central and South America, the tyranny under Jesuit-trained Castro in Cuba and throughout the Caribbean, and the terrorism in Lebanon and Ireland today are the Vatican's handiwork. Now can you see why God calls the Roman Catholic cult the mother of every abomination on earth? Revelation 17:5. The Vatican knew that after World War II, many people were wise to the fact that the war was a Vatican Inquisition. So they had to use one of their famous diversionary tactics and open the John Birch Society to get everybody thinking and talking about communism, which the Vatican also sponsors, instead of the true culprit, the Vatican. This was a great success for them. The Vatican also sponsors every major terrorist group in the world. The reason for this is to keep people's thoughts on unexplainable, insane tragedies that their terrorist groups are committing, while the Vatican is busy undermining all governments of the world so they can have world dominion, papal power. When terrorist news hits, it is so shocking that it minimizes the news of the Vatican taking away the U.S. Constitution and of people being deprived of their religious freedoms, being jailed, schools and churches being closed. This is the real thing that the Vatican is after, though. World control of our religion and our government. The more insane, bizarre, unreasonable, and unexplainable the terrorism is, the better. The Vatican's heavyweight news media also keeps you busy, thinking about it all. Now that they are exposed with their modus operandi, they will soon, with their media and the President of the United States who just joined them, be the driving force of a campaign to stop all this terrorism that they have created themselves, to make everyone believe that they are good and godly and that they could have never sponsored anything like this. Update, such as Terry Waite negotiating in Lebanon. Jim Jones, a Roman Catholic Jesuit deacon, posing as a Christian, was sacrificed, not with poison Kool-Aid, murdered along with his flock by the Vatican to make the world look narrowly and suspiciously upon innocent Christian retreats. These six things doth the Lord hate, yea, seven are an abomination unto him: a proud look, a lying tongue, and hands that shed innocent blood, and heart that deviseth wicked imaginations, feet that be swift in running to mischief, a false witness that speaketh lies, and he that soweth discord among brethren. Proverbs 6:16-19. All these things that God hates, the devilish Vatican is. Did you ever notice that with the Vatican-controlled U.S. Customs and Immigration, we cannot get out of this country without going through the third degree, searches, radar, etc.? But in the 1960s, when Jesuit Vatican-trained Timothy Leary led our nation's youth into drug addiction, Immigration and Customs seemed unable then, as they do now, to detect tens of thousands of pounds of narcotics and drugs entering into our once fair nation via the Mafia, which launders all of its illicit, ill-gotten gain, all its black market money, through the Vatican. Maybe this is why President Abraham Lincoln said, "I see a very dark cloud on America's horizon." And that dark cloud is coming from Rome. Look at what the Bible says about the Antichrist that caused all this corruption and shed all this blood. "And I saw the woman, the Vatican, drunken with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus. And when I saw her, I wondered with great amazement." Revelation 17:6. "How much she hath glorified herself and lived deliciously, so much torment and sorrow give her. For she saith in her heart, I sit a queen and am no widow, and shall see no sorrow." Revelation 18:7. "These governments have one mind, and shall give their power and strength unto the beast." That is one world government. State and federal, civic and social government agencies included, powered by Satan, giving that power unto the Antichrist by carrying out her orders. Revelation 17:13. These are some of the very last signs in the Bible's book of Revelation, before Jesus comes back to earth again, and time shall be no more. God destroyed the world by water, Sodom and Gomorrah by fire and brimstone. On both occasions, God sent messengers preaching the forthcoming doom. Today, God in His infinite mercy warns all Roman Catholics, "Come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues." Revelation 18:4. If you are one of God's people, obey the word by coming out of her. Why? Because to not do so is disobedience, and disobedience is the same as witchcraft. Many Vatican, state, and federal government agencies such as the IRS, OSHA, and the U.S. Department of Labor, along with labor unions, have wonderfully destroyed the economic backbone of our country by harassing and forcing hundreds of businesses and industries into bankruptcy and out of business. This leaves millions of Americans out of work and hungry, while Vatican-run enterprises are not harassed at all, but they flourish because they run the government agencies. Look at what God says about the Antichrist when he will be thrown into hell. They that see thee shall narrowly look upon thee and consider thee, saying, Is this the man, the Antichrist, that made the earth to tremble, that did shake kingdoms, that made the world as a wilderness and destroyed the cities thereof? Isaiah 14, 16 and 17. Feds okay Vatican slave labor camps. Just one of the Vatican's many multi-billion dollar enterprises is their liquor and wine slave labor camps, which have no labor problems whatsoever because they unlawfully use free labor, thousands of Roman Catholic monks. These federal government agencies will not allow anyone else to enjoy the same privileges of volunteering our labor to God, our Father, and our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, because we are all heretics, non-Roman Catholics. Yes, their enterprises do prosper with no harm or harassment, using free labor in their Christian Brothers, LaSalle, and Benedictine liquor and wine distilleries, slave labor camps, and in many others all the way from Napa Valley, California to New York State. The Vatican's IRS and U.S. Department of Labor now cross the constitutional dividing line of separation between church and state, and in every way are attempting to destroy all fundamental Christian churches and schools. One way is by taking away their tax-exempt status. This anti-American, anti-U.S. Constitution organization, the IRS, however, has given tax-exempt status to all communist organizations in America under Internal Revenue Code 501(c)(3). They have never made any attempt to take this status away from them. Note, up until 1987, all communist organizations were tax-exempt. Now, because of my literature, they removed the tax-exempt status for all communist parties. However, the Vatican communists are so entrenched into government under the guise of Republicans and Democrats that they no longer need exemptions, not to mention the government grants that are given to their pseudo-charitable groups and multi-billion dollar government grants to parochial schools and other elite Catholic communist organizations. Rome's collection agency, the IRS, has also made sure that the Roman Catholic cult and all those affiliated with it, the One World Church, are the only religious organizations in the U.S. that don't have to pay property tax or even tax on their multi-billion dollar businesses. This is done under Section 892 of the Internal Revenue Code. The Vatican is the only religion that receives multi-millions of dollars of federal aid each year for their parochial schools. This comes out of your tax dollars. Like Archbishop Gilroy says, ourselves alone for fellow Roman Catholics, and we must defeat all heretics. The Vatican has used the Communist Party to help destroy the Russian Orthodox churches, and she used the Nazi Party in her attempt to do away with the Jews and their synagogues, because the Vatican says that all others than themselves are heretics, non-Roman Catholics. IRS, Roman Cults Collection Agency. The Roman Catholic Jesuits started the international banking system called the Illuminati and the Agentur, and blamed the Jews for this. Rome's motto is, "He that holds the money bags runs the nations." The Vatican started all the wars, inquisitions, to rid the world of heretics, non-Roman Catholics, and then made loans from her banks to nations so they would have enough money to fight them. We foolishly permitted this cult's collection agency into our country, the IRS, which answers only to Rome. According to God's law in the Bible, every 50 years there should be a clearing of debts that can't be paid, a relief. This is called the Year of Jubilee, Leviticus 25:10. Let's bump cultish Roman canon law of death and bondage and get back to God's law and His Son, Christ Jesus. Let's have a clearing, the Year of Jubilee. These debts have been instigated by Satan, the Roman Catholic cult, to hurt us and to put us into financial bondage. We didn't start these wars. We didn't want these wars. We didn't borrow that money. So why should we have to suffer? These wars were all Roman Catholic inquisitions to mold the world into a one-world government, church, and media. At the One World Church Convention in Vancouver, some of our volunteers were shocked by the pro-homosexual booths and literature, pro-witchcraft booths and literature, drunkenness and total ungodliness which this universal, world's largest cult and sect exalts. These satanic people call anyone that preaches the true word, which is separation from evil, consecration unto good. They call this a cult or a sect, but they worship this one world organization and its cult leader, the Pope, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he, or a soon to come Pope, as God, will soon sit in the temple of God in Jerusalem, showing himself that he is God. 2 Thessalonians 2:4. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish. 2 Thessalonians 2:9-10. They kneel and kiss his ring and feet and call him Holy Father, which is forbidden in the Bible. They obey his every wish by calling us a cult who walk in the Spirit and obey God's every wish. They have possibly committed the unpardonable sin, blasphemy of the Holy Spirit, which is never forgiven in this world nor in the world to come. Matthew 12:31-32. But Satan does not care because he already has blasphemed the Holy Spirit. The mark of the beast. Satan wants you to spend eternity in hell with him. And to cause you to do this, look what he, through his state and federal government agencies, has cooked up for you now. Government enforcement of a law making it necessary for you to take a mark on your hand or your forehead in order to be allowed to buy or sell. This could be done invisibly by using laser beams. God calls this mark the mark of the beast. Revelation 19:20. The Vatican will use some pretty name for it. The mark of peace, love, unity, fellowship, etc. And God says, if we take this mark, we will go to hell. Revelation 14:9-11. the Pope, the super boss, and his federal and state government agencies will say that if we don't take this mark, we will be boycotted, can't buy or sell. I'll trust God to feed me, just as he fed the Hebrew children for 40 years in the Sinai desert. And God will do wonders again for his faithful followers who resist the Pope, his government agencies, and the mark. President Reagan has been bewitched too by the Vatican's craft, just as other world leaders have. This is obvious by his sudden move of sending our U.S. ambassador into the big Roman whorehouse, this cult's home office and general headquarters. Mr. President, you're hanging around far too much with those Jesuit-trained One World Church ministers, and they're giving you some really bad advice. Is it the Vatican money and the big Vatican backup that's causing you to become part of this cult? Would you sell your eternal soul by joining yourself and our nation to the Antichrist for money and temporal power? The Lord asks, "What shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own eternal soul?" Mark 8:36. By having done this, you're now in big trouble with the living God. Lest you straighten up and fly right and publicly recant your decision so that the Lord and the public know where you stand exactly. Respectfully, Mr. President, in the name of Jesus, I say these things to you. We're at the end of time, and the day of the politician is over. We all have to let people know what's in us. The Bible says that he who receiveth not reproof from God's word is brutish. Proverbs 12:1. Mr. President, and all you presidents and kings of the world, there is a judgment for all of us, and I believe it's coming real soon. A true Israelite believes God. I'm not a theological seminary man. I am a true Israelite, washed in the blood of Jesus, filled with the Holy Spirit, and sent by the Lord to preach Jesus crucified, resurrected, alive, and soon to return to this earth again. I have full authority from heaven to preach this. A true Israelite is one who believes God, which most Jews don't, because they reject the Messiah by rejecting the over 300 scriptures in the Old Testament telling of the Messiah. Some Israelites have converted to this sect, Roman Catholicism. The Vatican wanted them to become rabbis so that they could place them in the Israeli Knesset as spies. Some of these Roman Jesuit rabbis are there today as spies. In World War II, Poland was the strongest Vatican-controlled country. If the Vatican loves Jews so much, then and today, why did she allow the slaughter pens of the most Jews to be in Poland? Why did the Vatican forge the anti-Semitic document, Protocols of the Elders of Zion, blaming the Vatican's desires for world rulership on the Jews? Why did she blame the schemes of the Vatican's international bankers, Illuminati and Agentos, on the Jews? And why does the Vatican have spies posing as rabbis in the Knesset if this anti-Semitic Roman Catholic cult loves the Jews so much? God says, "O my people, they which lead thee cause thee to err and destroy the way of thy paths." Isaiah 3:12. The time of the Messiah's second coming is now, so repent or perish, which means accept the Messiah and the atonement, which is his blood. which he shed for your sins, or perish, which means you will go to hell if you don't. There are religious leaders who are leading millions of people to hell because of their connection with and exaltation of the Antichrist and his cult.
That's something really, really special the Lord has blessed us with tonight. Tony Palmer, I asked him to come give his testimony, and he's got a special message for us tonight.
And I said, listen, next week I'm going to Kenneth Copeland Ministries Ministers Conference. I said, there's going to be thousands of leaders, and these guys have their jets. They've got TV shows. And I said, they've got churches of 10,000, 2,000, 20,000. I said, these are big fishes. He said, why don't we make a video? Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, mio fratello, mio vescovo fratello, Tony Palmer, del vostro compagno, del vostro raduno, con piacere vi invio un saluto. E famiglie che non si vogliono, famiglie che si uniscono e famiglie che si separano. E noi siamo un po', mi permetto la parola, separati. Separati perché i peccati ci hanno separati, i nostri peccati. I malintesi nella storia, ma una lunga strada di peccato comunitario. Io la nostalgia che questa separazione finisca e ci dia la comunione. Io ho nostalgia di quell'abbraccio di qua, ma dobbiamo trovarci come fratelli. Facciamo crescere la nostalgia, perché questo ci spingerà a trovarci, abbracciare e pregare al Signore perché ci unisca tutti. E avanti, siamo fratelli, ci diamo spiritualmente questo abbraccio e lasciamo che il Signore finisca l'opera che Lui ha incominciato. Di benedirmi e io vi benedico. Di fratello a fratello, un abbraccio. Grazie.
Glory, glory, glory. Tony, thank you, sir. Come on, the man asked us to pray for him. And since we know not how to pray for him as we ought, other than to agree with him in his quest and in his heart, all of these leaders represent literally tens of thousands of people that love you, that believe God with you. We receive your blessing. It's very, very important to us. And we bless you with all of our hearts. All of us declare together, be blessed. I'm telling you right now, heaven is thrilled over this.
Speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with a hot iron, 1 Timothy 4:2. Some are Jesuit priests posing as Christians. They and their organizations have been rewarded handsomely from Rome because they have herded unsuspecting, ignorant masses of their followers right into Satan's universal church, who has future plans for them all, taking the mark of the beast in the name of Christian fellowship, brotherhood, peace, charisma, and love. People have been easily led into this division of the Vatican's cult and think they are right because they received not the love of the truth that they might be saved. Follow not God's word exactly. Because of this, God said he would send them strong delusions that they should believe a lie, that they all might be damned who believe not the truth, but have pleasure in unrighteousness. the whole Antichrist setup. 2 Thessalonians 2, 3 12. These false leaders love the Roman Catholic money and political connections. It keeps them on national and international television. It helps build temporary little empires for themselves and unto their names, such as television networks, universities, villages, and many other vain business enterprises and supposed to be Christian fellowships. God says the getting of treasures by a lying tongue is a vanity tossed to and fro of them that seek death. Proverbs 21:6. These leaders exalt the papacy and support it.
What's your view of the current pope? You know, the pope has obviously been reaching out and has been a force of moderation in comparison to his predecessors. What do you make of it?
I think the pope is fantastic. You know, I just think his tone, his humility, his, you know, I loved when he said the other day, you know, and it's our view too. We're not trying to, you know, make this a little bitty narrow thing. Anybody's welcome. We may not agree, you know, 100% on doctrine and theology, but you know what? The church, Catholic Church, our church, it's open for everybody. So I like his tone, not pushing people away, but I believe God's big and his mercy is very wide.
They visit the Pope in Rome often and include the Roman Catholic clergy in most all of their social functions and allow them unashamedly on their television and radio broadcasts. They encourage President Reagan's moving our nation into the Antichrist, the Vatican. The Vatican promotes them, and they promote the Vatican, because they are just alike, liars. You can easily see them, and I think you know who they are. Just turn on your television set. Pray for their blind followers, because they trust in lying words that cannot profit. Jeremiah 7:8. And for these blind leaders who will not speak the truth, they have taught their tongue to speak lies, Jeremiah 9:5, who lead their blind, for Jesus said, both of them are going to fall into the ditch, Luke 6:39. Jesus also said, all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, Revelation 21:8, and they shall not enter heaven. For without are dogs, and sorcerers, and whoremongers, and murderers, and idolaters, and whosoever loveth and maketh a lie. Revelation 22:15. Because they are like him, Satan, who deceived Eve, and now the world. All death started with a lie. Jesus didn't come to bring peace, but a sword. Matthew 10:34. He came to show us the difference between light and darkness, good and evil, truth and lie, the body of Christ and the Antichrist. He said, my sheep know my voice, and another will they not follow. John 10, 3-5, Revelation 14:4. Do you hear Jesus' voice? Or the voice of the Pope? Are you one of the sheep of Jesus or a goat of the Antichrist? Do you like to hear lies or the truth, God's Word? Many of you have supported the Antichrist by tithing to these organizations. Support Christ, not the Antichrist, or you'll go to the same hell with him for supporting a lie. Secret Vatican agents disguised as Christians are going around to different Protestant churches to collect money to build the temple in Jerusalem for the Antichrist, Solomon's Temple. And ignorant Christians who think it not ungodly to be deceived, as was Eve, are giving them the money for it, instead of being discreet and godly and tithing to true Christian works. Jesus said, my people are destroyed go to hell for lack of knowledge. Hosea 4:6. Roman Catholic spokesmen are angry when the Word of God is preached and say that they cannot believe that in this day and age there are still people preaching hatred, bias, and prejudice, etc. But what these Vatican ambassadors are really saying, though, is that they cannot believe in this day and age that there are still people preaching God's Word, the truth, and that there are people that would have the guts to expose Satan. Them. The backslidden denominational churches that have merged with the Vatican say that nowhere in the Bible does God or His Son, Christ Jesus, answer back or command their children to answer back. In the Bible, from the book of Genesis to the book of Revelation, God, His Son, Christ Jesus, the patriarchs, prophets, disciples, and apostles answered Satan back on every point whenever his false doctrine came their way. We are commanded by Jesus to use the sword, the Word of God, to defend and preserve the gospel by answering Satan back on every point with zeal and boldness. We are commanded to answer back Satan's fallacies, twisting of the word, as Jesus did when he answered back the devil on the Mount of Temptation, Matthew 4:3-11. Paul, by the Holy Spirit, said, "Preach the word, all the word," 2 Timothy 4:2. Don't leave out the scriptures regarding the Antichrist, the false prophets, answering back, rebuking and reproving. Jesus said that we live, go to heaven, by every word that proceeds from the mouth of the living God. Matthew 4:4. This means the words about the Antichrist, the false prophets, etc. Because Jesus said, when we know the truth, all the truth, every word, the truth will set us free. John 8:32. But the Antichrist and his false prophets don't want you to be free because their master is Satan, who likes to keep people in bondage. If they do not want people to be in bondage, then why do they become so angry when the whole of God's word is preached, which sets you free from Satan? And why would they call preaching all the word evil, hatred, bias, and prejudice if they're not from Satan? The Antichrist and his false prophets say that we are not to do anything concerning serving God with passion. They say keeping God's commandments, preaching and doing God's word passionately, is sin. But in the book of Revelation, Jesus commands us to be zealous, or he would spit us out of his mouth. Revelation 3:16. Zeal and boldness, passion, are the bylaws of God and his anointed. We are commanded to do whatsoever we do as unto the Lord. Colossians 3:23. With the whole heart. Matthew 22:37. With zeal, passion, and if people are offended by God's word, any of it, God says that they are brutish, like beasts. And God also says that being offended or rejecting His word is sin. To reject the word of God is to reject Christ, and it is only by our acceptance, belief of the word which is Christ, that we become saved. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, the Word, and thou shalt be saved. Acts 16:31. The Vatican, through its mafia, first destroyed the morals of the country with pornography, prostitution, narcotics, manufacturing and distribution of alcohol, etc. Now, with false acts of piety, she is trying to bring in laws of censorship on all the smut that she herself has created in our nation and throughout the world. This is this cult's deceptive, vile way to make you believe that she is good, decent, pure, and pious. This is also her first attempt at worldwide censorship. Her second motive with this censorship will be to censor all speech, including the Bible, except the way she wants the Bible preached, which is the exact opposite of the Bible. She knows that the world is not aware of her satanic way of doing things, and the world that is not aware that she created all this smut and indecency in the first place will applaud her and worship her because of this premeditated, noble act. This is to lure everyone that is ignorant of her and her devices away from the Lord and unto herself. The future plans that she has for these blind people is hell. Misery loves company, and Satan and his followers don't wish to burn alone. They want you, dear heart, to share eternity with them in hell's torment. Do you want what they want for you? Or do you want what Jesus has prepared for you, which is everlasting happiness with him, away from all evil, away from all deception, and away from all possibilities of any kind of harm? Get right with God. Don't live for this temporary world, which is so brief. Plan your future eternally by learning about the plan that the Creator and Ruler of the universe has made for you, by rejecting this obvious satanic cult's plan of rulership of the world by the devil and his Roman Catholic cult that is so vain and brief. If you don't, it would show God that you are as satanic and defiant as this devil who calls himself God's vicar. God himself on this globe. Get right with God right away before it's too late, like it already is for the devil. His smoke from hell shall ascend up forever and ever. Revelation 14:11. Come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool, through the blood of Jesus. Isaiah 1:18. In God's love, he sent to die for us that which he loved the most, his Son. Jesus loved us so much that he laid down his life and shed his blood for us, so our sins could be purged, forgiven. If we love as God and his Son, Christ Jesus, have loved us, then will we give up our sins and former wicked way of life, learn the Word of God correctly, and give his truths to this world that has been lied to for so long, that they may have this life that God and his Son have given so freely. But how can they know without a preacher? Not a novice, but one who has learned all the ways of the Lord. But if ye refuse and rebel, ye shall be devoured with the sword, for the mouth of the Lord hath spoken it. Isaiah 1:20. If you would like to be saved, then say this prayer, and you will be. My Lord and my God, have mercy upon my soul, a sinner. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. I believe that he died on the cross and shed his precious blood for the forgiveness of all my former sins. I believe that God raised Jesus from the dead by the power of the Holy Spirit, and that he sits on the right hand of God at this moment, hearing my confession of sin and this prayer. I open up the door of my heart, and I invite you into my heart, Lord Jesus. Wash all of my filthy sins away in the precious blood that you shed in my place on the cross at Calvary. You will not turn me away, Lord Jesus. You will forgive my sins and save my soul. I know because your word, the Bible, says so. Your word says that you will turn no one away, and that includes me. Therefore, I know that you have heard me, and I know that you have answered me, and I know that I am saved. And I thank you, Lord Jesus, for saving my soul. And I will show my thankfulness by doing as you command and sin no more. After salvation, Jesus said to be baptized, fully submerged in water, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Diligently study the King James Version Bible and do what it says. The Lord wants you to tell others of your salvation. You can become a distributor of Pastor Tony Lamo's gospel literature. We'll send you literature free of charge. Call or email us for more information. Share this message with someone else. If you want the world saved as Jesus commands, then don't rob God of his tithes and offerings. God said, "Will a man rob God? Yet you have robbed me." But you say, "Wherein have we robbed thee?" In tithes and offerings. Ye are cursed with a curse, for you have robbed me, even this whole nation and this whole world. Bring ye all the tithes. A tithe is 10% of your gross income. Into the storehouse, that there may be meat, spiritual food in mine house, souls saved. And prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sakes, and he shall not destroy the fruits of your ground, neither shall your vine cast her fruit before the time in the field, saith the Lord of hosts. And all nations shall call you blessed, for ye shall be a delightsome land, saith the Lord of hosts. Malachi 3:8-12. Here are some more of the Pope's secrets. The Vatican is so mysterious that most of the priests, nuns, and members on the lower level of their clergy and people who work on the lower level of federal government agencies don't know that they're part of the world's largest cult and that narcotics, prostitution, pornography, booze, and the black market, every filthy thing, can be traced right back to the Vatican and her government agencies. Defectors from this large sect, the Roman Catholic cult, have stated that 68% of the Vatican's clergy are guilty of homosexuality, lesbianism, and fornication. All these acts are absolutely forbidden by God and will cause their souls to go to hell if they don't repent. Down through the ages, many notables have called the Vatican a sewer of corruption. A former high-ranking Jesuit priest who worked in the Vatican for years and answered only to the Pope reported to me that when today's Pope, John Paul II, was a priest in Krakow, Poland. Factory workers became angry with the future Pope, John Paul II. It was reported that many of the factory workers wanted to kill him, and they stated that they did not want him to come around anymore. And when he would, they would throw oily rags at him because it was reported that he was molesting their little children. They also reported that he, now John Paul II, is a homosexual. This explains all the new Vatican federal government regulations regarding non-discrimination against homosexuals. In a book about love, lust, that Pope John Paul II wrote when he was a priest, he repeatedly quotes Sigmund Freud as though he were quoting Holy Writ. Sigmund Freud, a Jew who converted to Roman Catholicism, is well known as the world's foremost pervert. Satan, through the Vatican's one world government, church, and media, raised him up, along with the whole psychiatric field, to do away with the world's sin and guilt. The Vatican could then use psychologists and psychiatrists to commit to mental institutions people who profess faith in God's supernatural dealings with mankind, both today and in the past. These psychologists and psychiatrists and the Vatican's heavyweight news media continuously mock, make fun of anyone who exposes through God's word this cult, which God calls the whore in Revelation, and anyone who stands on every word of God, which includes Christ's commandment to raise the dead, to heal the sick, to cast out devils, to be born again, to resist and expose the devil, the whore of Revelation. John Paul II and Freud's perversions run parallel, as he admits in his book. Now that he has hit the big time, ruler of this Roman Catholic cult and the federal government agencies, he can make laws in accordance with the way he thinks. He now wishes for us to live out his fantasies by making laws forcing both young men and women to have to use the same toilets in college dormitories. His perverted brain rejoices as he sees the human race forced by law to participate in his style of kink. These new Roman canon laws of perversion and death are forced by two of his federal government agencies called the Department of Housing and Urban Development and the Department of Education, which sound very official, and it makes them as much of a disguise as the whole Vatican operation's false Snow White image. In the spiritual war between God and Satan, we rejoice and are exceeding glad because Jesus said, "Great is your reward in heaven, for so persecuted they the prophets which were before you." Matthew 5:12. We are the strongest fundamental Christian organization in the world and are very proud of that fact. Some false publications which perjure themselves, some that deceptively even print Bibles and do not listen to Jesus, who said, "Do violence to no man, neither accuse any falsely," Luke 3:14, have included us in their books about cults. Because of their blatant lies and because of our necessity to uphold the integrity of the Lord's word, we had to check out these sinister publications. And of course, we found them to be run by the Jesuit Vatican cult. "What mean ye that ye beat my people to pieces and grind the faces of the poor, saith the Lord God of hosts?" Isaiah 3:15. "Don't you know whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap?" Galatians 6:7. "And God will do to you manifold that which you have done to others. Vengeance is mine, I will repay, saith the Lord. I will recompense." Romans 12:19, and Hebrews 10:30. We are joyful because our reward is great because of the lies that they have told about us. Jesus said so. Matthew 5:11-12. The Vatican's federal government agencies and our heavyweight news media, in concert, have also made it possible for us to have much great joy and abundant rewards in heaven because they have jointly taken us into court on false charges and have launched slanderous campaigns against us continuously for the last 15, now 50, years. Under investigation, we found both the heavyweight news media and, of course, the aforementioned government agencies, secretly Vatican-controlled and or owned. We thank you and praise you, Jesus, for showing these facts to us and for guaranteeing us our most certain rewards. The psalmist David writes, "The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from us. He, God, that sitteth in the heavens, shall laugh. The Lord shall have them in derision. Then shall he speak unto them in his wrath and vex them in his sore displeasure." Psalm 2:2-5. Fearful reward for those who fight against God. Include in your prayers all these unfortunates who fight God, his Son, Christ Jesus, the Holy Spirit, and God's anointed. For if they continue on, there is a certain fearful reward for them. We, like our Father which is in heaven, and his Son, Christ Jesus, don't wish that anyone should go to hell. That's why we instruct all people to pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that they can find Christ as their personal Savior and start doing good by working for him instead of doing the unfruitful works of unrighteousness, the end of which is everlasting hell and damnation. Not that we pray for the devil or for those that have blasphemed the Holy Spirit. We pray not for them. 1 John 5:16. Our church has expanded and grown much stronger, as Jesus said we would under persecution. If God so loved the world, shouldn't we? This expose is written in love, so that precious souls won't be deceived by the Vatican and her associates anymore. Take the mark of the beast and go to hell. Everyone who uncovered facts about this cult, the Roman Catholic cult, and her associates, has historically and right up to this day been called heretical, vicious, dangerous, secret, religiously bigoted, etc., and has fallen prey to her massive character assassination campaigns. They also say that we have Vatican paranoia. Did Abraham Lincoln and John F. Kennedy have Vatican paranoia? And all the millions of people today who are being hassled and harassed by the Vatican's federal and state government agencies, plus those who don't have a job and are hungry, some sitting in jails because they were forced to steal because of hunger. Do they all have Vatican paranoia? Because of this expose, the Roman Catholic cult will act as if they, of all people, are being persecuted and will say innocently, "Why is this happening to us?" Knowing that those who are ignorant of the things she does will feel sympathy for her. I have no sympathy for the devil. I didn't write the Word of God. I just preach it. God doesn't hate good, only evil. The Vatican and her people all deserve the Academy Award Oscar for the best performance of innocency and piety, and also for makeup and wardrobe design, making her outward appearance that of Snow White. Underneath her Snow White outfit, there are running, festering sores and ringworm. On the outside, she smiles sweetly and says, "I love you, brother." But behind her bony back, she hides hands that drip with the blood of martyrs. Here is an example of how the Vatican always covers herself. When she saw World War II, another Vatican Inquisition was being lost, she quickly hid in one instance 1,000 Jews, so that after killing 6 million Jews, she could say, "We hid and protected the Jews. We love the Jews." This is the actual truth of what the Vatican did. Speaking of Academy Awards, the Vatican has long time been in the movie industry. Hollywood, influenced by a powerful Roman Catholic lobby, furnished us with films like The Song of Bernadette, Going My Way, and a number of exciting films glorifying this Roman Catholic cult. On the other hand, they pushed movies like Elmer Gantry, showing crooked Protestant evangelists. Do you remember Dragnet on television? The Christian was always pictured with a big Bible, smiling after he had strangled Grandma up in the attic. And always the priests were the well-respected, highly paid stars like Bing Crosby and Barry Fitzgerald. You see, we are hit psychologically on many fronts by the Vatican. The leader of the One World Church and all the world government. Continuing her role as Snow White, the Vatican is using her own media to promote a three-hour CBS propaganda extravaganza, whitewashing her clay god and cult leader. I'm sure the oily rag-throwing incident was left out of the script. There are many beautiful people in the Roman Catholic cult who are not wealthy, some are even very poor, and who are not seeking for high position. Most are very humble. These common people are completely unaware of the wickedness that has been and is being committed by the Roman cult, which they have been told is a church. Because God knows their sincere hearts, He is the God of our heart. He says unto these ignorant people, "Come out of her, my people," Revelation 18:4. So let's pray they will soon. A grim reminder to the satanic superboss, the Pope, who runs the Roman house of prostitution and the governments that give her power. "Your reign is very short-lived, thus saith the Lord. For in 1 hour, so great riches is come to naught," Revelation 18:17. "And her smoke rose up forever and ever," Revelation 19:3. "And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet," Revelation 16:13. The Jewish priesthood ended at Calvary. Nowhere in the Bible has God ever given authority of priesthood to Italians, Poles, or any other race of people other than the Jews. And out of the 12 Jewish tribes, only from the tribe of Levi did God bring forth priests. This shows that the Vatican is unscriptural and living in a world of fantasy and make-believe. When Jesus said, "It is finished," Jesus became the only high priest, John 19:30. The Vatican wants to move from Rome to Jerusalem. On September 26, 1973, the Houston Chronicle reported that the politically power-hungry Henry Kissinger helped this super cult, the Vatican, by proposing that Jerusalem become an international city with the control of holy places and the religious administration being given to the Pope. The Bible never mentions purgatory or any similar sort of place, but the Bible does plainly say, it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this, the judgment. Hebrews 9:27. And God said, it's either heaven or hell, nothing else. You can't buy your way into heaven, and you can't buy your way out of hell. Nowhere in the New Testament does it say to kill people who don't believe the way we do. The Vatican, however, calls such killing holy war and condones it, proving again that she is completely cultish and unscriptural. 50 years ago, Archbishop Gilroy said, because of our Catholic control of the post office, the postal department has the means of checking the whereabouts of certain non-Roman Catholics, heretics, in regards to their movements and certain situations. And while we have such men in control in our post office and in your service, we need not be afraid of our secret police being criminally detected. Knowing these facts, it is clear why the Postal Department is currently trying to take away our bulk mail status. They are criminally suppressing freedom of speech and freedom of religion, our two last constitutional guarantees that the Vatican is quickly and quietly trying to do away with. State and federal agencies, with their news media and judicial systems in every nation, under the instructions from Rome, will certainly say that the Pope's secrets is hate literature, and they will tell you that I am your enemy. But as the Apostle Paul said, so say I. Am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth? Galatians 4:16. Telling the truth so that people can escape world dominion under the cruel leadership of Satan's vicar with his hateful and dictatorial Roman canon principles instead of our godly U.S. Constitution, which is law in the United States, and so that people of all nations can escape the mark of the beast and hellfire. Is that hatred? Jesus said that telling the truth is love and commands us to go into all nations preaching the truth. For Jesus said, ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. John 8:32. You can either believe the Pope or me. I have revealed unto you just a few of the Pope's secrets. God said that the Pope's organization is the mother of every abomination on earth. Not 99% of the abominations, but every abomination. Read your King James Version Bible and see if I am or am not telling you the truth. Believe God, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Acts 16:31.